Welcome to Lab 360, for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. A new era in astronomy starts in July. Ever since December 2021, we have been patiently waiting for the JWST to start operations in full capacity. NASA had told us time after time that the Webb telescope will be fully functional in summer of 2022. It brings us great joy to tell you that you can finally save the date. The first full-color photos and spectroscopic data from NASA's James Webb Space Telescope, a collaboration with the European Space Agency and the Canadian Space Agency, will be released on July 12, 2022. Webb has been going through a six-month phase of preparation before it can begin science work. It is calibrating its sensors to its space environment and aligning its mirrors and living up to its name as the largest and most sophisticated observatory ever launched into orbit. Years of new technology development and mission planning have culminated in the first photographs and data. A display of Webb at full capacity, ready to begin its science mission and reveal the infrared cosmos, is muchly awaited. We are on the verge of an extremely exciting moment of discovery about our universe, as we near the end of preparing the observatory for science. Webb's first full-color photographs will provide a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for us all to pause and wonder at a vision that humanity has never seen before. The first photos and spectroscopic observations will be taken after each of Webb's instruments have been calibrated, tested, and given the green light by its science and engineering teams. To put Webb's powerful capabilities to the test, the team will go through a list of targets that have been preselected and prioritized by an international committee. The production crew will then receive data from Webb's instrument scientists and transform it into photographs for astronomers and the general public. So, what can we expect to see? While thorough planning for Webb's initial full-color photographs has been ongoing for some time, the new telescope's capability makes it difficult to forecast how the first images will look. Of course, there are things we're hoping to see, but with a new telescope and this new high-resolution infrared data, we won't know until we see it. Early alignment images have already proven Webb's infrared view's unrivaled sharpness. These new photographs, on the other hand, will be the first to be in full color and to show off Webb's full scientific capabilities. Webb will capture spectroscopic data, which is comprehensive information that astronomers can read in light, in addition to pictures. The early cosmos, the evolution of galaxies through time, the lifetime of stars, and other worlds, are among the science themes that inspired the project and will be the focus of its work. Webb's commissioning data, which includes measurements acquired while aligning the telescope and configuring the equipment, will be made public as well. You must be wondering, what's next for Webb? In simple words, science. Webb's scientific observations will continue when it captures its initial photographs, continuing to examine the mission's main science themes. Teams have already filed for time to utilize the telescope in what astronomers refer to as its first cycle, or first year of observations. The official start of Webb's general science operations, the task it was built to undertake, is marked by these observations. Webb will be used by astronomers to observe the infrared universe, evaluate the data, and publish scientific publications based on their findings. Aside from what is already planned for Webb, astronomers cannot predict the unexpected findings. For example, dark energy was completely unknown before the Hubble Space Telescope was launched in 1990. It is now one of the most fascinating fields of astronomy. This just gets us more excited for what Webb will learn in the future. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. NASA's James Webb Space Telescope is just weeks away from full operation, with its mirror segments perfectly aligned and scientific equipment undergoing calibration. Webb's in-depth science will begin soon after the first observations are made public this summer. The lava-covered 55°E and the airless LHS-3844b are two hot exoplanets, designated as super-Earths, due to their size and rocky composition, and are among the investigations scheduled for the first year. Webb's high-precision spectrographs will be trained on these planets in order to better comprehend the geologic diversity of planets throughout the galaxy, as well as the evolution of rocky planets like Earth. 55°E orbits its Sun-like star at a distance of fewer than 1.5 million miles, 1/5 the distance between Mercury and the Sun, completing one round in less than 18 hours. The day side of the planet is supposed to be covered in oceans of lava, due to surface temperatures being higher than the average melting point of ordinary rock-forming minerals. Planets that orbit their star this close are thought to be tidally locked, with one side always facing the star. As a result, the hottest place on the planet should be the one that faces the star the most directly, and the amount of heat emitted during the day should remain relatively constant. While 55 Concrete E will reveal the fascinating geology of a world engulfed in lava, LHS 3844b will present a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to study solid rocks on an exoplanet's surface. LHS 3844b, like 55 Concrete E, orbits its star very close, completing one revolution in 11 hours. The planet, however, is not hot enough for the surface to be molten, because its star is small and cool. Furthermore, Spitzer's observations show that the planet is unlikely to have a significant atmosphere. While Webb won't be able to image the surface of LHS 3844b directly, the lack of an obscuring atmosphere will allow spectroscopy to be used to analyze the surface. The researchers will utilize MIRI to capture the thermal emission spectrum of LHS 3844b's dayside, then compare it to spectra of known rocks like basalt and granite, to figure out what it is made of. The spectrum could reveal the presence of tiny amounts of volcanic gases, if the planet is volcanically active. The significance of these discoveries extends far beyond just two of the galaxy's more than 5,000 verified exoplanets. They'll open up incredible new perspectives on Earth like planets in general, allowing us to learn more about what life was like on the early Earth when it was as hot as these planets are now. Webb's Cycle 1 General Observers Program will undertake these observations of 55 Concrete E and LHS 3844b. We're just a few months away from obtaining much-awaited valuable data about these kinds of planets. To summarize it all, consider what might happen if Earth were substantially closer to the Sun. So close that a year is only a few hours long. Gravity will have confined one hemisphere in perpetual scorching daylight and the other in unending darkness because they are so close. So close that the oceans boil, rocks begin to melt, and lava starts to rain from the clouds. While nothing like this exists in our own solar system, these kinds of planets do exist somewhere in the Milky Way. What are the true characteristics of these planets' surfaces and atmospheres? Stay tuned, as the James Webb Space Telescope is about to deliver some answers. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. Welcome to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. While NASA's James Webb Space Telescope is moving through the final phases of commissioning its science instruments, work has also begun on technical operations of the observatory. As the telescope moves through space, it will constantly find distant stars and galaxies and point at them with extreme precision to acquire images and spectra. However, NASA plans to observe planets and their satellites, asteroids, and comets in our solar system, which move across the background stars of our galaxy. Webb needs to be able to lock onto these objects and track them with sufficient precision to obtain images and spectra. The Webb team recently completed the first test to track a moving object. The test verified that Webb could conduct moving target science. As the team moves forward through commissioning, they will test other objects moving at various speeds, to verify that they can study objects with Webb that move throughout the solar system. Webb can detect the faint light of the earliest galaxies, but the team will be observing much closer to home. They will use Webb to unravel some of the mysteries that abound in our own solar system. Planetary scientists use telescopes to complement their in situ missions, missions that are sent to fly by, orbit, or land on objects. One example of this is how Hubble was used to find the post-Pluto target for the New Horizons mission, Arakov. However, the telescopes are also used there are no in situ missions planned, like for the distant ice giants, Uranus and Neptune, or to make measurements of large populations of objects, such as hundreds of asteroids or Kuiper Belt objects, since NASA can only send missions to just a few of these. The Webb team has already used an asteroid within our solar system to run engineering tests of the moving target capability. Our solar system has far more mysteries than any team could have the time to solve. But programs such as this will observe objects across the solar system by imaging the giant planets and Saturn's rings, exploring many Kuiper belt objects, analyzing the atmosphere of Mars, executing detailed studies of Titan, and much more. There are also other teams planning observations. In its first year, 7% of Webb's time will be focused on objects within our solar system. Another exciting and challenging program in the works is to observe ocean worlds. There's evidence from the Hubble Space Telescope that Jupiter's moon Europa has sporadic plumes of water-rich material. Scientists plan to take high-resolution imagery of Europa to study its surface and search for plume activity and active geologic processes. Teams at NASA have been planning for Webb observations for decades, and that has gone into overdrive now that the observatory is launched, deployed, and focused. Do you think Webb will find microbial life in our solar system? Will it be able to tell us if Europa and Titan can harness life? Drop in your comments to let us know, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy.